right, so what's up, Gary?
Yo, what's going on?
And how are you guys doing out there, too?
Yeah.
We're bordering on the new frontier of Super Omega Soul.
We're the new generation.
Generation Z.
We're essentially like an evolved version of a starter Pokemon at this point.
Yeah. So basically, we want to do a little bit more content other than, showing video games and we started off doing LPing, but I think we plan on going back. But just to kind of stay fresh for ourselves and for you guys, we want to kind of do a conversation kind of type video.
Well, so I think it's kind of beneficial to do it because in our videos, we tend to kind of focus on where we talk to each other back and forth. It's never really been kind of like a personal thing with the viewer. So this kind of puts a little thing like more into our personalities.
Yeah,
other than just our...
I think what Gary's trying to say is like we're trying to involve you too.
Yeah, yeah.
In less words. But I completely understand what you're trying to say.
I tend to overcomplicate.
Oh, I do too. Don't worry about it, man. I'm like tangent, man. I just go off of like these tangents. But another reason is because there's a lot of times where we're having conversations that's basically what we talk about. It'd be interesting, at least we think it'd be interesting to hear, you know, like top video game news and, you know, life topics and all this other stuff.
Yeah, because after we finish recording, a lot of times we end up just having like in-depth conversations about random topics.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, things that we should probably cover anyway.
Yeah.
So just to start off, we hope, depending on how you guys like it, depending on how much support you show, we'd probably maybe do it a weekly thing, maybe a bi-weekly, depending on how it goes. But yeah, you let us know if you really like it, and we'll continue doing it. So I think to start off, I know we've been getting a slight little rumors of the Nintendo NX.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'll be honest, I had no interest in it when I first heard. They're like, oh, we're making another console. Like, here we go. But I think it was you who told me, like, now there's rumors of a cartridge style.
Yeah. Supposedly, it's more akin to an older stock console where it's like more cartridge.
Which I think all of us are kind of getting like little squirrel girls. We're like, ew.
If you grew up in the 80s, 90s, and like late 90s, yes, this should excite you because more than likely you grew up playing cartridge based games.
Yeah, and I mean, Nintendo is like the master of that, right?
Yeah.
Which is fine. I mean, we're going with disc, but. You know, I think what really interests everybody when they say cartridge, I don't really think they mean older games. I think what we're hoping for is that they're talking about the 3DS games.
That's a huge thing for me because right. I love Monster Hunter.
Exactly. Yeah.
And I hate playing on the 3DS.
What's the game on it? Like some of the Fire Emblems, I really like them.
But they're stuck on this tall, small screen.
I don't feel like staring at a little screen for which like is, 3 hours.
Which 3DS is fine if you're like on a road trip or if you're just on the road or something.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Exactly.
But when I'm at home, I tend to want a bigger screen. I don't like laying in bed playing a small screen.
Right. It's just, it's very awkward if you're not like 15.
Yeah.
I mean, if you're any other age, if you're like 20 or 30, I mean, it's just, it's awkward because you're an adult now. You don't have time to just sit around and just look at a little screen. I mean, usually you're moving around. And before we go off of that, yeah, this is what's so cool about this concept is that we can finally sit down, look at our TV and play the game, no matter how crappy the resolution is, but we were able to play it on our TV.
Supposedly.
And that's why I'm kind of like, I'm really hoping this is what it is. But somewhere in the back of my heart, I'm like, Nintendo, you don't screw this up, man.
Well, the funny thing is that a lot of people don't actually realize that cartridges are still viable nowadays. Like common people just assume that it's all about CDs now. But cartridges can hold just as much as a CD can. So it's an interesting thing going back to it just because it's different technology. But it's a, to me, personally, my attachment would be more of a nostalgic thing.
Yeah, exactly. You and I, we both, or Yeah, you and I, we both grew up in the age where cartridges were kings.
Yeah.
You know, like, I mean, and Super NES was for me, and Nintendo 64, yeah. You know, and then PS1, that's when it started to kind of change up. Yeah. But even then, you know, cartridges were king. And yeah, our fondest memories are in that, you know, kind of...
I mean, who doesn't remember blowing on a cartridge to get it to work?
Yeah, I don't know. Did that ever really work? It felt like it did, but I don't know.
I remember, I think AVGN talked about this. Yeah. And he said that it theoretically may have worked.
Right.
But what it actually does is that it makes your moisture from your mouth corrode the pins inside the
cartridge. Right, yeah, exactly. It does more damage than good.
So it may work for the moment, but you're doing long-term damage to your cartridge.
I think, if I remember correctly, the correct thing you were supposed to do is get like a cotton swab or something like that and kind of like clean it.
Yeah.
That way you get like the dust out, but you're not, like you said, you're not putting any moisture in there.
Yeah.
But, you know, we were all dumb kids, you know.
It worked that one time, so we just figured it was going to work every time. So
Nintendo never said, hey, this is the official way you clean
it. Well, they used to sell, like, some weird thing you could stick into your cartridge. I remember that, because I used to have one. I don't know if those things actually worked or if they're just, like, cashing in on people's ignorance of it.
It's when you remember, like, the PS2 era when GameStop would sell those, like, disc grinder cleaners. Remember that? It was like a little contraption
that they had one in the store.
Yeah, but you could kind of like, it got to a point where you could buy one.
They used to charge like $5 to buff your disc.
Or it was just like this machine that like grinded your
disc. Yeah, I remember that.
Just to get all the
I didn't know you could buy one though.
I think it, like near the end it got to that point. But then immediately after we went to like better disc, so it just kind of like it went away.
Yeah,
like it went away with all the Suncoast and video like stores like Blockbuster
and Hastings. Yeah, you remember Hastings?
Oh yeah, I almost got a job there.
Hastings.
Oh yeah,
that was like the one place where they used to sell like little niche books and stuff that like no one on the island ever like sold.
Well, not only that, but it was one of the only bookstores that didn't feel pretentious.
Yeah.
You know, it was like, oh, you know, I come here and read. No. Yeah. You know, it was just like, no, you come in, you sit down, and you relax.
I remember they used to have, like, this nice little lounge area. It would just sit down.
Yeah, and maybe that was its downfall. It was too cool. It was too good.
I think the internet age kind of brought a whole lot of things down.
Yeah, really. Because, I mean, the Hastings here, at least, you could buy books. You could rent games and movies. It was still in that era where you could rent like video game consoles.
Yeah.
And that's where I first found out about Kingdom Hearts. I rented it there. I had seen it so many times before, and I'm like, this looks like the dumbest game. Like, what is this little boy with Goofy?
I think that was the impression everybody got initially.
And then I played it, and I could not put it down. I was like, I got it, and I had to return it before I beat it. And that's how I found my love for it. I also got into, like, anime there.
I remember they used to sell hentai.
I think that's where I first got introduced to Evangelion.
Yeah.
It was, like, through Hastings, and... I also found out about Fist of the North Star there, because like they sold the like high quality like manga that was being sold here. They had it there, and I read it, and I was like, oh my god, I just got blown, you know, my mind got blown. Yeah, I mean, so many good memories from Hastings.
All that's there is the specs.
Yeah, all there is a liquor store now.
There's just memories.
All right, so you know, moving on. How are you feeling about the new Pokemon Sun and Moon?
Honestly, I've never really been. Since, I think the last Pokemon game I played was Platinum.
Platinum? Have you tried any of the new ones? X and Y?
Not the new ones, no. I tried a little bit of Black.
Okay. X and Y is when they start kind of changing it up.
Yeah.
Let's see, the last one I really played was like one of the original ones. Like Yellow, Red, all those. Like OG.
That's like way back.
Yeah, OG, like Pokemon games. And then I jumped into the Nintendo 64, like Stadium and all that.
Which is kind of a shame we've never gotten a continuation of
that
series.
Yeah, that kind of spoiled it for me. That's why I had such a difficult time going back to, like...
the sprites.
Yeah, and I was like, well, I can just play it on 3D. Like, why do I care? But X and Y has done, like, a pretty good job of, like, recreating, you know, Pokemon Stadium in a way. What Sun and Moon's doing is actually pretty cool. Like, they are... they're really changing up the atmosphere. And not only that, the aesthetics of the...
I saw that it's kind of more open world. Where it's actually... You actually see more detail as to when you're walking around and stuff. It's not just an overhead view.
Yeah. Well, as far as I know, there's like 4 islands.
Yeah.
I didn't know there was like a snow area in the island. I guess it makes sense because there's like a tall volcano or something.
You're not a fan of snow waves. It doesn't
look that bad.
But you obviously like that Shadow of the Colossus inspired
game. Oh, God. What is the game called? Something.
Pray for the Gods?
Yeah, Pray for the Gods.
It shows how much of a hypocrite
you are. No, it does not. Shadow of the Colossus supersedes snow
levels. Yeah, but it's snow levels, and you hate snow levels.
But Shadow of the Colossus supersedes it, so it's okay.
No, it does not.
Well, when it comes out, we're going to play it. I know that. So anyway... you got like 4 islands. They're doing the whole Hawaiian vibe, which is I think is pretty cool. I'm surprised they haven't done something like that before. Honestly, X and Y is the first that kind of started changing up the aesthetics of it. X and Y had more of like a modern, like European / American Western vibe, you know. But what kind of sucked is Omega Sapphire Ruby, or what? I don't know. The freaking remakes.
Yeah.
They went back. So it was cool because it was a 3D now, but you kind of went back to it. But Sun and Moon's kind of bringing back, okay, now we're going into a different area.
Okay.
Of the world.
So they're kind of focusing on a different setting, essentially. It's just...
yeah.
It looks different. It feels different. So it feels fresh.
Right. It's like the Hawaiian Islands.
Yeah.
Which is cool. I like it. What I like is that they're... a lot of the Pokemon feel like they're kind of giving them the Islander feel.
Yeah.
Which is kind of cool. One thing is that they're giving old Pokemon new evolutions.
Yeah, I see Exeggutor there.
You see the Alola form?
Yeah.
Everybody's been riffing on it because it's got like a...
I don't think it's bad.
When I first saw it, I'm not even joking. I thought it was a joke. Like, I thought someone just, like, created, like, a fake, like, oh, this is what he would look like if he had a new, like, evolution. And it was like, oh, no, it's legit. Like, this is real.
Well, it seems kind of simple.
Yeah.
But, like, I feel like they could have added, like, more branches or...
right, like, if each head
more
had
spread out, just had, like, each head had its own, like, little environment going on.
Yeah, actually, that would have been cool.
Like, right there, it just kind of looks like that,
it just looks like a giant stick.
That, Mortal Kombat versus DC fatality, where, Quan Chi used to jump on you and just stretch your head. it obviously looked like it was a glitch more than an intentional fatality.
I think somebody was drawing it, and they, like, you know, like, when you're, like, driving and you're drawing? Oh, not you're driving and drawing, but when you're riding in a car and you're drawing, and then you hit, like, a bump in the road, and, you like, your pen just kind of, like, skirts, 2 feet. Like, that's what I feel like the artist was doing. He's like, oh!
Oh, well, too late.
Well, you know what? That's not bad.
That's it. That's the final design.
Keep it.
I mean, like I said, I feel it's kind of simple, but for the Pokemon, like, I can see it happening.
It is what it is. I'm not gonna hate on it. The weird thing is that they're giving was it Vulpix and Ninetales new evolutions, which is like kind of cool. It is a little weird now, but it's cool that they're giving love to the old generation.
Yeah, it is, but some of the designs for the new Pokemon kind of put me off.
Well, you mean new, or like the new evolutions?
Not new now, because I don't know enough about the new Pokemon now make an opinion on it. But we've talked about this before. You remember the keychain Pokemon
and all this other crap? That up,
That's when I actually stopped, I stopped keeping up with it.
I think that's when... they just kind of went too far. Like, it was a keychain.
ice cream one, I think.
Yeah, the ice cream, the sword, the chandelier.
The sword is... It's a little shark jumping a little bit, like a little dolphin fin jump.
It's still too much. But, yeah, it was obviously, like, there was no a quality manager there.
No, it's just like whatever. No,
that's so stupid. You need to go back.
Whatever got drawn, that's what was submitted for the day.
It was, they fire the quality manager, and he's just like, nope. Yep, that, oh, what, sword? Yeah, okay.
Let's go, just go get everybody drunk in the office and get my master plan submitted.
I think what's more insulting is that the chandelier Pokemon is in the fighting game Pokemon tournament.
Yeah.
And it's like, why? Why is he there?
Someone out there likes him.
There's a big fandom for him.
Somebody's gonna hate because we probably don't know the fucking names to these things. So you know Pokemon fans are super tryhard.
Yeah, they're pretty tryhard.
So we're like skirting on the edge of like
we're stomping everything.
We started off on a strong subject considering which Pokemon we're talking about for our first podcast video.
Hey, we said we kind of skipped some generations. All right, yeah, we don't hate on us for that. But what was I gonna say? So, you know the starter Pokemon now, right? You have, like, I don't know the names. I think one's called Litten is the cat.
Mm-hmm. I've seen them. I don't know the names, but I've seen them.
The owl one, and then, like, the little, like, sea lion seal. Fine. Apparently, there have been, you know, leaks of their final evolution.
Sounds like something I'd rather avoid.
Well, okay. Do you want to hear or not?
No, I want to hear it. I want to see them. That's what I mean.
Oh, you don't want to see them?
No.
Okay. Well, if it's true, I don't know. You know, again, these are just rumors and leaks. I saw the pictures, and they're actually pretty cool. They look like really goofy, like, starter Pokemon. I wasn't impressed by how they looked, really. But their final ones are, like, pretty cool. If it's true, the owl has, like, this final design where he kind of looks like he's wearing like a hooded robe.
Yeah,
he looks like almost like Robin Hood, where he's got like the little like kind of hood over his head. And there's even one design where he looks like he's shooting an arrow.
That's different.
It's pretty weird. I mean, it's probably not a real arrow. It's probably one of his feathers or something. The seal looks like a. It looks more like a female seal. It looks very, like...
Because when I first saw them, it's kind of like... They looked cutesy. Like, yeah. Extremely cutesy. And yeah. I was like, I'm not sure how I feel about this.
Yeah.
Like, but it's like evolutions tend to go. They tend to look a little more mature. Usually. By the end of, like, their last form.
Right.
So that's what I kind of look forward to having if I choose a starter. But...
The seal looks like something that comes out of, like, some aquatic circus show. Where it's, like, it looks very elegant, but it looks like it'd be something in, like, Ringling Brothers or something.
Yeah.
But the cat is the most interesting one. Because that, if you had to guess, I don't think you would ever guess what it's supposedly going to be.
What, it turns into cat dog?
No, it looks like it's gonna be like a luchador style.
What?
Yeah, it looks like a wrestler type. It's like really buff.
Is that who you're gonna choose?
It's a pretty strong contender.
Well, this is assuming I buy it. I kind of am interested in the owl, just because. Yeah.
The owl and the cat are like top like ones I might choose. It's been a while since I've chosen a fire type, so I might go with the cat.
Oh, the cat's fire.
Yeah, cat's fire. Okay. Owl's water, grass. I'm assuming. Yeah, water. So yeah, man.
Wait, how is the owl grass?
It lives in the woods. What's it's grass flying?
Okay.
So it's one of the few ones that has two. So yeah, man, that's pretty interesting stuff.
Well, assuming how it is, because I'm probably gonna hear it from you to see how the game is. I might pick it up.
I'm very like hyped a little because. I like X and Y, and I did like Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. There we go. I remember the name. This one, it's doing all the new location. A lot of the Pokemon designs I'm kind of digging. They're showing love to the old ones, but what I'm really kind of interested in is they're doing this new thing called Z Moves, where it's like your trainer does like this style of Hawaiian dance, and it like activates like the special from your Pokemon, and the special is it's dependent on what type they are. So water has a unique like final special, grass has a unique final special.
It's just kind of like ultimate moves, essentially. Just
right, it's like if Goku did a spirit bomb.
Yeah.
But they all kind of look different.
Yeah.
Now, the thing is, will every type have a different one? Like, will Ghost have a different one? We'll have
Steel, imagine,
Rock, and all that.
Imagine it'll probably be shared based on types.
Probably. That's what I'm hoping. Because if that's the case, then that's going to really make it interesting.
I've always been like a huge fan of Ghost Pokemon, so
yeah,
I'm kind of excited to figure out what it is.
Yeah. Oh, and they're in Japan. No word if it's coming out here in the States, but they're going to be selling like these bracelets that have like these little crystals that kind of looks like the your trainer has in the game.
It seems like a thing you might get beat up for.
Yeah. Well, I mean, this is for the kids, right?
Well, I don't know, man. Pokemon goes.
There's a lot of 30-year-old Japanese men going to be wearing these.
It's a lot of 30-year-olds playing Pokemon Go more than kids. So we should probably make a video on that.
But yeah,
it's probably going to come here.
Yeah, I think so.
Or people will import it.
Yeah, or people will get like super butthurt. Yeah. Like, oh, no, I want my bracelet. But apparently, like, there's going to be like a gem for each type.
For each. Attribute type?
Yeah, like ghost,
yeah.
Psychic, fairy.
Wait, does this thing light up or does it do anything?
Yeah, it does light up.
Okay.
From what I understand, it lights up and it makes sound. So when your character in the game does like a Z move, it lights up. So it's almost like you're doing it with it, you know? Like
so is this like connected to your 3DS to where you can do this or?
Okay, remember when Heart Gold came out and Soul Silver,
yeah,
and they came out with like the little like God, I always forget what it's called. It's it counts how many steps you take.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about. I don't know.
Yeah, I always forget. It's something thermometer or what? Thermometer. Yeah. It's not a thermometer, but it counts your steps, and apparently that would link up to your DS, and they would somehow. I think it had something to do with like hatching eggs or something. I don't know. I think that's what they're kind of going for. Like, if you have the correct gem and you're using the correct Pokemon, maybe, I'm just guessing, it may, like, give a boost to the attack.
That's kind of skirting on kind of broken.
Yeah. Well, first, the tournaments would never allow that.
No.
They're not going to be like, oh, well, everybody has one, nobody has one. So I doubt that would be in, you know, competitive play. And I don't really think it's necessary. I think it's just something for the kids to be like, oh, you know, like imagine if they give you the ability to do the Kamehameha motion with Goku. I think that's what they're kind of going for. Like, you're doing it too.
We need, like, Dragon Ball Z VR.
Yeah.
Like, we can just do the Frieza fight for realsies.
That needs to be, like, full VR. Like, you're, like, submerged in a tank.
Yeah, something. That's what I mean. I mean, you like Cell so much, you can be Gohan. Just do, like, just father and son Kamehameha.
Do hyperbolic time training and all that crap. Yeah,
maybe then we'll lose weight.
Yeah, one day. One day it'll happen.
I'm just waiting for VR to get for real.
Can you put my brain in this thing now?
Can I just do VR and simulate me exercising, but not really?
And live in this computer.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's basically what's going on right now. Unless there's something else you can think of?
For Pokemon? No.
Oh, well, just news. Gaming news. It's been pretty dead. I'm trying to think.
There's probably something.
Oh, No Man's Sky. That's...
Oh.
Okay, so have you heard all the news coming out?
It got leaked.
Okay, I heard a guy bought it beforehand.
Yeah, he's on Reddit.
But he... From what I understand is that he didn't leak anything. He had the option to.
No, he did.
And then... Well, I heard he wrote... He was like, oh, you know, I'd rather hold this experience for you guys and let you...
No, he did.
He leaked the whole thing?
He was leaking videos of it. Oh, but they were getting taken down.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, I read that. Where he was just... But from what I understand is that they were just, like, very early, like, beginning of the game.
He was just showing, like you basically, yeah, it's just not, really nothing we haven't seen.
Right.
But it's gameplay that's not supposed to be shown yet, so.
Well, there's been a lot of trailers that have come out that have kind of given way more details. And now I kind of understand what the game is more about. Because before I was just like, I don't know what this is.
Like, well, it's like the Hello Games, that's the developer. Yeah. Their whole thing was, we don't want to show you
too much
because then it will spoil the game for you. But I'm very skeptical, especially when it comes to games that promise me like randomly generated worlds. I'm just like, all right. Based on my limited understanding of it, I don't claim to know the whole thing. Yeah. I'm just like, I don't care if you tell me you're using some fucking mathematical
some formula Einstein.
That's just going to show me every single little thing I can possibly think of. I don't care if you tell me that.
Yeah.
There's only so many assets you can add to the game.
Yeah.
Okay. How many times am I going to see the same fucking dinosaur, only this time with its head where its ass should be? This is what I'm thinking about, and I know it probably sounds stupid to somebody who understands it.
Right. No, I understand what you're talking about. And they did bring that up in the trailer.
Yeah.
I mean, they said that technically with this algorithm, there's like an infinite, well, not infinite, but there's almost like to the point of almost reaching infinite levels of creation where they're gonna mix things and blah blah blah, colors and head and styles and all this. Now, one thing that, like you said, what really depends on that is the assets. How many heads have they created? How many body shapes have they created?
But apparently, yeah, like you said, this has been stated, but apparently it is possible for it to create random assets.
Oh, okay.
That's what the algorithm does.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it can create basically whatever.
Right.
So, if it works the way it's intended to, everywhere you go, it's just going to be a different thing. It's not dependent on art or things created by the actual developers. It's mostly based on whatever the algorithm does.
Yeah.
So...
See, I understand that concern. My concern is when they start talking about, I'm doing air quotes, multiplayer, because technically there is and there isn't multiplayer. Like, from what I understand, at this point, you cannot, like, lobby up with people. Like, there are lobbies.
Yeah, but...
But it's like Dark Souls. Like, I can't say, hey, let's come play one game together. Let's go.
Well, now you can.
Well, yeah, they can. But the original OG style, you couldn't do that. Remember, we used to...
Hey, go put your sign down next to the merchant.
Is your sign there? No.
And hope it shows up.
Oh, I guess we're not on the same server.
Well, we're not playing. That's why we originally got Dark Souls, the original one, together.
And we never. I think got one to time. Play. At one time. We never got to play together. Welcome.
Then you just dropped it.
Welcome to No Man's Souls, because that's what happened.
You went hollow, right out of the gate.
I just stay there waiting. But yeah, I mean. To me, that's the part that's kind of like, I don't know, because, yeah, I mean, I think it'd be fun to go exploring and to do all this cool stuff, but eventually, you know, if you make a world too vast, it feels empty, right? But if you make it too small, it feels too cramped.
Well, depending on how it actually simulates space...
Yeah,
I'd be for that, because that's if you go to space, that's what I imagine it's gonna be like.
Right, and I understand that, but at the same time, there's that sense of like you got to pull it back a little bit.
It is possible to run into people.
Well, okay, they said that,
but
you may not even know they're there.
Yeah,
which is kind of like okay. I mean, that's cool because it makes it more interesting if I run into some bro I didn't ever really seen before. But I think this is a prediction. For me, Jay Nostradamus.
Yeah.
That eventually, maybe like a year or two down the line, we're probably gonna start getting. We're probably start gonna get updates where they're starting to make it like more.
Like more social.
Yeah, I that's what I'm feeling.
It could happen, but I think it depends on how the initial reaction to the game is. If that's a, like a huge concern people are voicing, they may sway to make it a little easier to meet up. If not, then it could end up being like Minecraft in space. Who knows?
Well, the thing with Minecraft is you can hook up.
Yeah. So, but it's not in space.
Yeah.
It's not simulating space.
That's my prediction. I think that's maybe a year or two down the line, people are going to be like, I want to... Either they're going to beg for it so much, or they're going to mod it to where you can, like, do it.
I mean, there's... That's fine and good. Like, I could sit down and play Minecraft for a bit. But I need something more than just crafting and naming different animals and stuff. And I don't know if that game has anything more than that.
Well, from what I've heard, there's also, like, 3 alien races that are in the game.
Yeah.
What they said is that when you meet them, you won't understand them.
Yeah, you can learn their languages.
Yeah, but what, like one word at a time, which I was like, okay, that's bullshit, but that's kind of cool too, you know?
But is that like, is it just making random languages everywhere you go? No. Does it have like audible sounds? Because if you go to like another planet like 50 billion light years away from the other one you just learned, it's like, is the language going to be similar? Like, how many, like, if it's audible, it's got to be, like...
A little different.
It's got to be different.
What I'm thinking is, because it is 3, like, 3 specific races, I feel like they've kind of put in a little more thought into it. If they were to said, okay, aliens are just going to be, like, randomly generated, then, yeah, I'd be like, okay, then it's probably just whatever language, you know. But since they said 3 specifically, and they seem to be a little bit more centered around the story, I feel like maybe they put more thought into it.
It's going to be, like, similar?
I don't know. They didn't say.
But, that's the thing, though. It's like, even here on Earth, like, Japan, that's a good example of it. You go like, mainland Japan, like Tokyo, people sound like city folk. But then you go someplace else, like Osaka and stuff, people have, like, they're considered freaking hick. And they have a different dialect from people.
You're in the talking mainland. About, like...
Even so, that close to each other, there's still differences in dialogue.
I don't think it'll go that far.
But then how am I supposed to get immersed?
Well, they'll probably have, like, different... all 3 will probably have different styles.
I don't think...
But if you're expecting... For one alien race to have, like, 3 styles within its own style.
So, is this just limited to the story?
That's what it sounds like.
Or you're never going to run into, like, aliens and...
No. Well...
This is what confuses me about the game.
Yeah, me too. Because I don't know. What I understand is you will come across them. Or pirates. I don't know if the pirates are part of the alien races as well. But you will be encountering some type of alien... faction or force when you're traveling around. I don't know, I mean there's so much. I've learned so much, but yet I feel like I still don't know.
I don't want to seem like I'm a huge Debbie Downer or something. I want the game to be good, because I would like to play a game that's actually good, like a space sim.
Yeah,
I mean, we got Star Citizen, but that's like not...
When is that coming out?
It's not. I mean, it might at some point.
They
but
just gave up. They're like, nah.
It's being updated, but it's gonna be a long time for it's actually done.
Yeah, it's still in... I'm doing air quotes again. Beta.
Yeah, or alpha, whatever you want to call it. Yeah. But we got that game for PC, since we play on PC now.
Yeah.
So I'm just like, how much is this game limited by consoles? Because it's also on consoles. Star Citizen is not limited by consoles.
I don't know if the... I also read you can technically play offline. So technically, the game is always generating, like, worlds, even if you're not connected to the internet. So I don't think it's connected. Like, I don't think the PSN network is connected to, like, the PC network or servers or whatever. As far as I understand, they're not, but they may. I don't know.
That's really how I feel about the game.
I don't know, maybe you guys are in the watching this can tell us. I don't know what you think about this. My thing is, what I'm excited for is you can name the planets. How many people are going to just name them, like, retarded things?
Well, there's probably going to be a filter.
I hope there's not. I hope there's just, like, you can name it whatever you want.
There's going to be a filter.
Like, I Dick Butt the it. Planet. Yeah.
Well, I don't know. Man, no. I don't think they'll allow Dick Butt, but...
You know, like, Assy McGee the planet. You know, like...
Probably it's going to be a filter for words you can't use.
McAngus.
Because people are gonna, there's going to be little kids playing it.
Quarter pound my Angus the planet.
American culture is, you can see a person getting beheaded, but no, don't say ass in front of my kid. Yeah.
Well, that's how it is, man. Well, I guess that's going to be it for us. It's a pretty good conversation. I mean, like we said, the news week has been pretty slow.
And for next time, we can probably look up, like, actual...
Ah, sure. But, let us know what you guys think. I'm very excited to keep doing it. But if you feel like it's not a big deal or whatever, let us know.
This will be a video, I guess, on top of what we usually do.
Yeah.
Shouldn't stop anything we've got going on, I don't think.
Unless there's something... No, I mean, well, this will never be a replacement for other videos.
Yeah.
But if for some reason we can't upload a video, I mean, maybe we can always upload one of these.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, let us know what you think. We had fun doing it, and we'll see you guys next time.
Later, guys.
All right. Peace.